What is up, you guys? Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I'm gonna be filming for you guys my curly hair routine. I'm of course filming this after I did my curly hair routine. This is my hair fully done, fully dried. I'm basically gonna be showing you guys what I do, from how I wash my hair to the products that I use, to how I put my products in, to how I diffuse my hair. A little backtrack on my natural hair journey. I've actually been natural now for about 3 years, but I kind of started to get strict with it the last year and a half or so. I recently did a big chop back in August, and I've been growing my hair out now for September, October, November, December, January, February, March, and March. We're in April now, so technically it's been 8 months, going on to 9 months. And this is like the curliest that my hair has ever been since transitioning. If you guys want a more in-depth video on my curly hair journey, my transitioning journey, my natural journey, comment down below. But so we're just gonna get right into this video. I love you guys so much. Thank you guys so much for watching, and let's get right into it. Okay. So, I'm not sure if I'm gonna make this a voiceover or talk through, but I did wanna talk through at least the first part of my hair, which happened already. Didn't film it because I have terrible lighting, but basically what I use to wash and condition my hair is the OGX Perco. Basically what I use to wash and condition my hair is the OGX. It's the OGX Prakashi Oil Line, the Recovery Deeply Restoring, you know, whatever. I just started using this. It's like my second time using this. I actually really like it. It makes my hair super duper soft, and it smells really good. Got it from Target, you know, good old Target. So pretty much what I do in the shower is I usually would just shampoo once, condition once, and then do a mask. But today, because I had a previous hairstyle in my head, had lots of gel, edge control, beeswax, whatever, I shampooed twice. So for my first shampoo, I just got a good lather on like my scalp, you know, because you're not supposed to put shampoo directly on your end. That'll dry them whole out. And then once I rinsed that out, I did a second lather just to make sure, you know, I got everything out. And to help with all the product off my hair, I used my little shampoo brush. I literally got this from Family Dollar. For a dollar. So you know, I'll do the usual scrub around, make sure everything's lifted, and then I'll flip my head over and, you know, massage my scalp to promote hair growth. And then I rinse that out, and once I'm done that, I just put my conditioner in. With my conditioner, I put that in, let it sit for like a minute, and then I'll like finger detangle it with my hands first, just to get like the bigger knots out, and then the little knots that like I can't really get out, that's where my dendron brush comes in, and I just detangle, like I just kind of like brush the front, back, all that stuff, and then I rinse. That's pretty much all I do for the shower portion of my curly hair routine. But let's get started. Okay, so the first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna section off my hair like so. Y'all, look at my hair. Like, look at it when it's wet. Like, look at where it hits when it's wet. It's nice and long, you know, it could be longer, but it's, you know, it's a decent length when it's long. As soon as this thing dries, it's just gonna, like, ugh. And I'm just gonna get my spray bottle with my little conditioner water concoction, and I'm just gonna respray the section, just to make sure, you know, I don't want it dripping wet, but I want it to where I can hear the, I don't know if y'all can hear that, but the, you know. And that's when you know your hair is going to absorb the product. You want your hair to take in the product. You don't want the product to sit on your hair. So first thing I'm going to use is the Miss Jessie's Pillow Soft Curls, but I just take that amount, and I just finger that through the first section of hair. So the second product that I'm gonna be using is the Camille Rose Almond Jai Twisting Butter Sweet Almond Milk and Honey. And I absolutely love, 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 love this product. And it smells like cake. It smells like cake. So I use about this amount because, you know, it's a heavier product, but it gives my hair the moisture it needs, but also the definition that it needs without, you know, making it too heavy. And a little goes a long way. I'm telling you, this product is magical. But yeah, so then I just take my Demon brush and I just brush through the sections. I pick up my hair when I'm brushing through just to make sure, you know, adding a little bit of volume. Because when you brush down with your Demon brush, and your hair is going to dry down. But if you brush up with your Demon brush, and your hair is going to, you know, be lifted. So I just grab different sections of my hair, like so, and I just continue to detangle and define with the Demon brush. So I think, since I'm pretty much gonna be doing the same thing to every section of my hair, I think I'm just gonna speed it up. And if I need to add a comment, I'm probably just gonna do that in a voiceover. So, and I kinda wanna listen to my music too, so. So pretty much what I do from here is I'll just take my microfiber towel once again, and I'll just like squeeze out the excess like water, product, all of that. Yeah. Oh, I think this is gonna come out nice. So the next thing that I put in my hair to top it all off is the OGX Nourishing Coconut Milk Anti-Breakage Serum. I just take like about a pump for each side. And this is kind of the only time I'll somewhat scrunch my hair, but not even. I just mostly focus on like my ends, and I like kind of just like pat it on there. Now that I'm done with my definition wet portion, product portion of my hair, I'm now going to go into diffusing my hair. Don't know if I'm gonna do it in here in my room, just cause the little outlet that we have, she a little loose. I don't wanna keep falling out while I'm diffusing my hair. I just might do it in my room. So I'll see you guys there. Pretty much what I use to diffuse my hair is the Curly Co. diffuser head. My dog keeps leaving me and I just... Oh, he came back! You wanna say hi? Oh! This is Zach. Okay, so my camera shut off because I'm losing storage in my phone. You might see these are the two things that I use to dry my hair. I just put my little diffuser head on. So the first thing that I do when I'm diffusing my hair is I don't touch my hair at all. I try my best not to touch it just to make sure that at least the cast of all the products and everything dry completely. And then I'll make sure that I get my roots dry. And that's when you'll see me start to touch my head, making sure that I get my roots dry. And then I'll start to dry my ends. Once most of the outer is dry, I will take off the diffuser cap and just use the blow dryer as is. And I do use it on cold. So we're gonna start diffusing. Yes, there's too many things plugged into this, and we're gonna speed it up now. Okay, so my hair is about, I would say 95% dry, like it's dry. So my hair looked a little flat as usual. So I'm just gonna go do my edges, then I'm gonna put my oil in my hair, and then I'm going to pick out my hair. So I'll be right back after I do my edgolos. Okay, so I did my edges, you guys can see. And now I'm just gonna be taking my OGX coconut milk serum once again, squirting that into my hand, working with one side at a time. But oh, y'all see them curls. First, I'm just gonna shake my hair out with my fingers. I'm just gonna take my pick. And I'm going to just... But pretty much, you guys, this is all that I do for my curly hair routine, and it's probably gonna get bigger throughout the day. The camera is not doing my hair justice right now at all. It's making me look like a frizz ball and I'm mad, but whatever. So you guys, an hour or so has passed since I filmed the last portion of me drying my hair, and I gave my hair, you know, about an hour to just finish air drying to get to its, like, you know, nice little state, put a little makeup on. But pretty much this is how my hair turned out. It's really defined. It's still frizzy. Like I said, I don't think I can escape frizz. If you guys know how to completely get rid of frizz, I mean, comment down below, but your girl done tried everything in the book. But yes, this is what my hair looks like after being dried and picked out. Pretty much it for this video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please make sure to like and subscribe and comment down below some other videos that you guys like to see from me. So that's pretty much it. So see y'all in the next video. Peace. Why do I always do that?